I started writing this book in the spring of 2002 when I was a youngish father with two small children living in a city still wounded from the attacks on the Twin Towers. Like a lot of people, I was looking for comfort in the familiar. Cecil B. DeMille's The Ten Commandments was on television, as it had been every holiday season since I was a child.
Behold his mighty hand!
Normally, I only catch the parting of the Red Sea. But that year, I saw it straight through from the beginning.
The theme of this picture is whether men are to be ruled by God's law or whether they are to be ruled by the whims of a dictator like Ramesses.
And I noticed something different. The credits ran, there's Charlton Heston, Yul Brynner, Ann Baxter, and all the rest. But I saw that the soldiers of the Pharaoh's army were played by the cavalry corps of the Egyptian armed forces. Now I realize that the most famous filmmaker in the world had shot the most extravagant production in movie history at the exact same time, in the exact same place. The penny dropped. I've been thinking a lot about Middle Eastern history and the events that led up to the attacks on the Twin Towers. I knew that 1954 in Egypt was a crucial time in the development of modern terrorism. I wondered if Cecil B. DeMille had made a deal with Gamal Abdel Nasser, the leader of Egypt's revolution, who had inflamed religious extremists with his secularism. The meeting that I imagined between these two men turned out to be real. I discovered there was a great untold story here. I thought it would be a cinch to tell it well and do it fast. 20 years later, I was just about finished writing Picture in the Sand. In the meantime, I went to Egypt 6 times. I met dozens of people who were knowledgeable about the era or who had been involved in the production. I started imagining the character of a young Egyptian movie fan named Ali Hassan who fantasizes about coming to the United States, changing his name to Al Harrison, and living the American dream. That dream seems within reach when he gets a job working for the great Cecil B. DeMille. But then it doesn't quite work out that way. Instead, Ali gets caught up in real-life events as dramatic as any of the movies he loves. He gets his heart broken and his liberty taken away. But somehow Ali survives, and ultimately he attains a version of his dream. A lot of people thought I was crazy to keep working on the book all those years, but something in the story of a young man yearning for freedom seemed bigger to me than the concerns of 1954, bigger than Nasser, even bigger than Cecil B. DeMille. It seemed like a story that could speak to people today. Picture in the Sand is a historical novel, but the frame of it is contemporary. Ali narrates it as an old man in Brooklyn, telling it as a cautionary tale to his grandson, who has run off to join ISIS.
It's a book I've been writing for a third of my life, because I had to. It's about the things I've always been obsessed with: faith, hope, terror, and the movies. 20 years.
Which is not such a big deal, considering Moses was out in the wilderness twice as long.